thought I'd make a video on why AAA is better. So you might have seen one of my older videos or someone like Jim Sterling where they shit on AAA games and say why they're a bad thing, which may leave you to ask, do you just hate gaming? What's the alternative? And where should things go? Well, that's simple. AA batteries. Let me go back for a moment. Back in the 70s to the 90s, there were about 1 to 4 people that would work on a game, or less than 20, for companies like ID Software and Valve. And it'd been that way for the majority of the games, even in the 90s all the way to the 2000s. And when they went to the 2000 age, people decided to go down the 3D route. So they didn't understand 3D quite well, so they needed more people to get into animation and so forth, and modeling and all that, and teams started to pick up, so it'd be like about 100 people or so, and they'd really pick up the amount of people that would work on a game. So it no longer was what we referred to as indie, which is short for independent developers, even though they would still have publishers like Atari and Activision, EA were still around at that point. They were still independent because they were smaller teams, which is generally what they define it as. And AA was what we didn't, I don't think we called it AA back then, honestly. I don't think we had a word for it. I don't think we even called it independent for the small groups, because it was just, that's all that really was. As you know, with AAA, it's anything under 200 people, and they call that a small dev team, which back then would have been like absurd. Back in like the 80s or something, I'd be like, what? 200 people working on a single game? They did everything from art styles to scripting. And now they just also throw loads of money at people for AAA industry. But back in the 2000s, they were doing like PS2 games that were all 3D, that they were AA, like Doom Raider, Resident Evil, Ratchet and Clank, Star Wars Battlefront, many, many more. And around the Xbox 360 age, some of them were still AAs, but they were going more over to AAA, where, and the PS3, Xbox 360, and PS3 age, because every console around that, by PlayStation 2's time, would last about 7 years, unless you're Nintendo. They started to go down the AAA route, which was entirely different to how things were in the game industry beforehand. Now there was a pre-order culture, and which is fucking stupid. There's stupid fucking pre-orders where you have to wait till midnight to get your game, and you can pay for extra versions with a doll, a big stupid plastic box that you just throw out in a week, $100 or more that you have to spend on these multiple different versions, which just creates scarcity and confuses you, the buyer, with DLC that are sold separately to the game on the day it's brought out, or you get early access to it, or some shit that makes you feel like you're a higher customer than the others because you've got a fatter wallet, you know. And one of the biggest changes for me was the change from that came with this, was away from it being something that was like any other job that you do for money, obviously, but you also more so want to choose this career over others because you're passionate about it and you want to make something that's artistically creative, you know, artistic freedom and all that. So one of the biggest shifts that I noticed immediately, apart from the pre-orders, of course, because that's what everyone notices, was the change from cheats and codes to achievements. Now, I actually had one of these books where I would generally save up my money to go down to the news agency that was just a walk away from my house, and we would buy these little booklets that like would hold all cheats and codes for games. They would like, they weren't always just like, oh look, you're invincible now, or something like level selection or whatever, which everyone thinks of them nowadays is just that. But there was stuff like big head mode, or give Ratchet a lightsaber instead of a fucking wrench, or turn your character into Jax, or give him a fucking a moustache or hairdo change or something like that. I just love that. That used to be the bomb. And that really changed for achievements, where some games we still have it, like GTA, that were known for their cheats and purely only that pretty much, where then they only got like 8 or so that would all disable sheets, and apart from vehicle spawns, they were all just like, look, I've now got ammo again, or I've got this gun, or vehicle spawning, or whatever, or I got more health. So, why do I say this? Why does this matter? Well, in Indie and Trip and AAA, everything that they put in matters and enhances the gaming experience. There's no wasted time, money, and resources. There's no shriveling horse testicles in the cold that they actually wasted 100+ hour work weeks just to develop that stupid shit that no one's even going to look at or realize. Everything felt like it had a place in the universe, that it would enhance the gaming experience. Some games like Doom wouldn't even waste time with story because they're like, there's nothing to add to the gaming experience by doing this. It's just a waste of time. Like, just get to what people come here for, which is to rip and tear until it is done. So, to get back to it, no wasting time or money, no grind, no way, because some games do have quite a grind, both in terms of padding for the story and gameplay and such, like climbing a fucking wall or doing a pointless puzzle in a fucking FPS shooter or something like that. There was careful consideration, and it felt like it was handcrafted. Like, there's a reason why people want to buy the handcrafted fucking wooden chair or whatever over a factory made one. That's because of the care and consideration that was put into the creation of this product, rather than, you know, what AAA gives, which the way I see it is AAA is just greedy and showboaty because bigger is better, everyone. And it's quite cynical, both in terms of how I see it and in terms of how they put it out and market themselves, which sometimes isn't even accurate to what they do because they're ever-expanding egos. And that's all it feels like to me, is just an ego rub for them, their games, more than actual art or something to be entertained by or enjoyed. I'm not a journalist, I'm a gamer. There's a huge difference in that. That's why AA is better, and I really hope the industry goes back to that. Now there's a pretty meme. Exquisite.